military-industrial complex that millions remain uninformed or
the system in the freezer, and Delph, I didn't even know that we OBS was locked up, showing me like it was still live. So I didn't even know that we were down, or whatever. So basically, what happens, and I still have yet to figure this out. I've talked to some of the top tier computer experts that I know of. Okay, for some odd reason, whenever my game PC goes down, my network suffers. If my raid fails on my game PC, my whole network in my house, internet, goes down. Shuts down. I don't know. I've never heard of this happening ever in my life except on this PC that I have, this game PC. I've asked a couple of my friends. I've asked a couple of people that are really, really, really deep into computer technology, and they have no idea what could be causing a network outage when a raid fails. Because it's not like just the game PC goes down. The stream PC loses connection. So when my computer overheated and shut down, it locked up OBS on the stream PC and cut the network. We dropped frames, but it cut the network enough so that OBS locked up and stopped streaming. This is something that, like I said, I've talked to people who've been in the business for decades, who've built PCs, who have world records in overclocking, and they've never heard and have no idea how this could be possible. So for me, I don't know, dude. Like, there's certain aspects to life where I'm just like, maybe no one has ever experienced this at all. Thank you for that, Bacon. See, mixer's working kind of okay right now. Yeah, so we're basically having some issues with the game PC overheating. It seems to be okay for now. I declocked the shit out of it. So, let's see if we can get this stuff done and get our summit done and at least get our rewards. Yeah, what's going on, Bacon? How we doing, man? Don't forget to check out exclamation point the lab or merch for new merch. I love the crew too. I mean, way more than Forza. And there's nothing else other than Forza. Like, the Crew 2 and Forza are the only only racing games out there. Need for Speed has been long in the past. You know, long in the background of racing games. Like, Need for Speed is supposedly releasing a game this year, and nobody knows any information about it. So I can only assume that it's going to be a pile of crap. So I'm just trying to get these pins done real quick. Yeah, hey Delph, when I saw you were no longer in chat, that's when I realized something was wrong. Like, I looked at chat and I'm like, Delph just left? I'm like, why would he just leave? Like, we, you know? And that's when I checked my OBS and checked everything. I'm like, oh, nothing's working. Well, no wonder. Yeah, so we're working on, I had a donation goal up for a CPU cooler, which I believe BMO's going to help me get. So I started a new donation goal for GIMP so I can get some courses done and learn a little bit. Oh, and this is just casual drifting too. I used to play with my wheel, which you can just, oh man, you just can't, you just barely see it, but yeah, I have a wheel, but I can't use a wheel anymore because I live in a double, and the downstairs neighbor, which I completely understand. It's not like, oh man, why are they complaining? But basically my pedals are too loud for them anymore, and they just don't. You know, I just don't want to disturb them anymore. Drifting is probably my favorite thing to do, besides going around and bullying people, just because that's fun too. Don't you do it! See, everybody wants to drive with me, but nobody can keep up. Excuse me, pardon me. We'll be right back. Man, 16,000 drift yards. It's got to be the longest one ever. Where's the airport? Let's just go to the airport. I'm just going to go drift in the airport. Get this done and out of the way. Hopefully our... Hopefully our PC does not. It just sucks, man. I declocked the crap out of it. We're almost there. We almost have it. Like I said, I think BMO's going to help me get the CPU cooler. And if after that it's not enough, I don't know what to do. But I'm pretty sure once we get the liquid cooler, we'll be fine. Completely fine. System was on fire. Thought you would not be back today. Oh, I'm going to declock the shit out of it. I mean, we're going to lose a little bit of performance. But here's the other thing that I love about underclocking in certain situations. Heat plays such a vital role in the performance of a CPU. You could have a CPU running at 67 Celsius at a banging 4.5 gigahertz. And it will run shittier than a 3.5, 4 gigahertz running at 40 Celsius. So heat just plays a huge role. So just in the fact that we're now, like, what are we sitting at now? So 71. So once this gets up to about 85, 90 Celsius, it just drops in performance. It's quite literal, and I don't know. It's just one of those things. Heat matters. Like, it doesn't matter how much performance you have. If your CPU is running hot, it's going to be crappy. So at least for this case, the game actually seems to be running smoother because the CPU is actually running cooler, even though it's at a lower clock speed. But yeah, Delph, we used to have a liquid cooler on it, and the liquid cooler that I had was given to me by somebody I no longer work with, and, you know, basically it was used, but it was better than my stock cooler, but it eventually broke. So now I'm actually trying to get a good one from a good company, Corsair, and I believe once we do, we'll be back in top tier gaming. If I can't play my racing games, though, if I'm going to be lost. Like, if I can't jump on the crew every once in a while to do some drifting or just to go around bullying people, racing, whatever, I'll be lost. Like, I mean, I started streaming racing games. This is pretty much all I would love to do. You know, like, if I can get my own place, too, or at least if I can live downstairs. You know, like, instead of being upstairs, then I can get back on the wheel. You know, we could pick up more racing. I've been looking into a set of Corsa. It's still a phenomenal game. There's tons of stuff that they've added to it. Modders have done phenomenal work with it. Like, a set of Corsa is probably the next, like, racing game I'd like to get into. Even though there's not much to do other than creating your own races and such. But I think there's a big enough community that I can get a couple people mess around with it. Like, especially with the drifting and the physics and, like, everything in a set of Corsa is so nice. They even have, I think they have customization too. But I don't know if that's just per car or what. Fortnite is bad. I mean, I don't think Fortnite is bad. I mean, it's definitely a good game. It's solid. I mean, I don't hear people complaining about bugs, glitches, and issues. And actually, even I think even Shroud, I think Shroud was the one to state that Fortnite players tend to be better FPS players than all other FPS players. So something about Fortnite, in Shroud's eyes, has actually produced better shooter gamers than even CS:GO, which is what he became popular playing. So as far as Fortnite goes, it seems to actually be increasing the skill of FPS shooters, and I think it's because of the whole building aspect of Fortnite. You're not just going around shooting, but you have this other aspect that's going to change the way you need to shoot or want to shoot, and that's the building in it. Now, I've never played the game I played it a little bit like four years ago. I don't know, a long time ago, when it was still before release. And I loved it. I mean, I love the idea of being able to like build a wall and, you know, sort of get out of a situation with a different, you know, feature or mechanic than just healing or, you know, throwing a flash grenade or something. So they incorporated something that I thought was really nice coming from somebody who doesn't care about FPS or Battle Royale games. Yeah, I mean, I can't say Fortnite's bad. I understand where the grievances come from with Fortnite, you know, both good and bad, but it's successful. It's hard to deny. Well, that's what I'm saying, Delph. Like I can only restate what Shroud says, and Shroud became popular through CS:GO. You know, the dude is a CS:GO god, and he stated, like, on Twitter or one of his streams or whatever that somebody quoted, that he believes that Fortnite gamers are better FPS players than other top-tier FPS games. Like, you can become a better FPS gamer playing Fortnite than you will playing CS:GO. Now, I don't know the context of why he said that, but I'm, pretty sure that, like, if somebody who played CS:GO, like, you know, is like, hey, man, Fortnite shooters are actually pretty good at FPS games. Maybe, maybe not, It's just, I guess it's just one of those things, like his perspective of things. I mean, he hasn't been in CS:GO competition in a while, so things could have changed. But I just know that was the one thing that he was like, you know, Fortnite is actually making better gamers, better FPS gamers. And maybe it's not the best, but, you know, like I said, context does matter. So maybe he was just stating, like, it's making everybody better in CS:GO or something. Fuck Battle Royale in general. Never liked it, although I was pretty decent. H1Z1 BR back in the day. Listen, I understand why people like Battle Royale, but I also don't think people should like Battle Royale for that reason. Like, oh, everyone's even. Like, because that's the other thing, too. Battle Royale is based. Yes, there's skill involved. Don't get me wrong. But your skill only comes into play based on what weapons, gear, armor, you know, buffs, debuffs that you have. So you could be the best player in the game, and RNG could just kick you in the ass constantly, you know? And that's what I don't like, and, you know, I've stated that before. RNG in games is the worst way to incorporate difference into a game. It's one of the worst development features I have ever, ever experienced in my life. I would rather, I would rather have to build up a gun. Oh, I gotta find a piece, gotta find a piece, gotta find a piece, gotta find a piece. Now I have a gun and I can shoot people. Then, oh, hey, this guy just dropped in. Rocket launcher, med kit. Like, well, how is that even no matter how much skill you have, the guy with the rocket launcher is gonna have, you know, an exponential amount of possibility over the guy who just picked up a med kit, you know? So to me, like when I see any game, and I'm stating this, you know, This is straight up emotional. But any game that incorporates any form of RNG is someone who does not know how to implement true difference. Like, there's nothing wrong to me. There's nothing wrong with grinding a game out in the sense of having to do a lot to get something than to just, oh, I was playing today and I got that gold card. Well, I've been playing for, 3 weeks and I still have yet to get a gold card. Or whatever it is, whatever game you're playing. Like with this, I could do a race, get a bunch of gold parts, but then somebody else does these races over and over like I have, and they're getting blues and purples. And it's like, well, they're achieving the same thing. They're getting the work done, yet they're not receiving the same rewards. And that, to me, that's bad implementation. Like, when somebody does something in your game, they should be rewarded for doing the action, Like, for instance, in Dauntless, if I break a behemoth's horn, I should get a horn part. Not a tail part, not a leg part, not a body part. A horn. I broke a horn, I should get a horn. But RNG makes it so that you have to just keep trying and hopefully you'll get that horn drop when you break the horn. That just makes no sense whatsoever. So for me, the alternative to me would be, instead of making it a 1 in 10 chance, how about you just make it, you have to break it 10 times to get all the materials needed to recreate or to recraft a horn piece. I would be fine with that. I'd be fine with a definitive objective that lets me know I can get this part as long as I achieve all parameters. Not, hey, I did it. Well, you didn't get it. Hey, I did it. You didn't get it. Well, I did it again, and you still didn't get it. So it doesn't matter skill. It doesn't matter, oh, I'm a tryhard, I'm a no-lifer, I'm a streamer. It doesn't matter. RNG is strictly the worst way to implement difference in your game or to implement, like, progression of a sort. If somebody is doing the work, they should get the reward. As simple as that. So RNG, I understand it brings longevity to a game. It brings people that want to grind more because now they didn't get the part, even though they did the mission, do the mission again and again and again. It keeps people. I get it. I understand it. But I'd rather move towards a grind idea than an RNG idea. So as much as I dislike the idea of grinding and having to spend, tons of time doing a simple thing to get something, I'd rather that over doing a lot of work and never knowing if I'm going to get it ever, So, all right, time to read. Okay, kind of want to make a deal with you. 2.5 weeks, I have my vacation. I'm going to pick up Scum. Like I said before, I'm going to rent a server for a month, if possible, maybe two. I want to see what's up with that game. And you got to join. I'll make you admin with all control. Dude, no problem. No problem, Delph. No problem, dude. No problem, man. No problem. Dude, you gave me goosebumps. You gave me goosebumps. All right? That's how I felt about what you just told me. How you feel about this, Sim? I have goosebumps right now. Like, I can't even tell you how happy I just became. That sounds awesome. I would love to work on your server. I would love to set it up. You let me know everything you're looking for. No problem, dude. I'm about to cry. No problem. No problem. I will jump on Scum this weekend. I will start setting up some things, figuring out the game, building and all that. I will try to get... I'll talk with RayKit. I'll hit up RayKit and be like, hey, listen. Let me know what you feel. I've been talking with RayKit. He's basically the... what I'm going to call the community manager. The unofficial community manager for Scum. He's like the only streamer, the only content creator for Scum right now. So I will talk to him. No problem, though. No problem. No. That's not a thing. You just let me know your time zones, which I'm pretty sure I know. Let me know your time zones, dude. I can always change my schedule. If I can get some gaming in with some people. That's no problem. That's why I enjoy kind of being unemployed. Like, oh man, you got time? Always. Always. I just need to know so I can change my sleep schedule and Now, if I was like a big streamer, Delph, and I was like, man, I can't change my schedule because, you know, this is where I got big, I could totally be like, yeah, I can't do that. But I'm not a big streamer, so I'll do what the fuck I want without any repercussions of people. We're totally cool. Yeah, so I got you, man. So I can change my schedule as well for the most part. All right. Oh, okay, we're done. So let's go do an event. Let's check our temps. I feel it getting warmer. 71. Okay. So I declocked it. I'm gonna see how far I can declock this thing. I'll put it back to 3.5. I'm gonna do some overclocking on this machine as well this week. See if I can't get my 3.8 back without having to increase the voltage. Oh, did I finally take it off of there? Why is it you know what? Voltage might be too low. So we're gonna bump up the voltage a little bit. I know it didn't overheat there. So I know that. So it's just too low a voltage right now. So I'm gonna bump it up. Twenty-fifth is your last work day. I think there's a... Okay. All right, I got you. So exciting. So yeah, that one wasn't to overheating. Or maybe there's another underlying issue. Maybe it's not overheating. I mean, I'm getting heated myself. I don't. already at 60. It just like 10 degree difference real quick. I very much dislike that song. Delph, did you check out the new base building and such? I recently posted a video in Discord about it. Like, they're starting to get some stuff done, man. Yeah, claim flags and stuff. You can claim land now. And if you destroy someone's flag with all their shit in it, you could place your flag in their area, and then all that stuff in that area is now yours. Like, there's some pretty crazy raid factors going on in this game. There has... I don't know. Maybe this isn't related to... I'll just keep messing with the clocks until we find some sort of stability. If anything, I'll go back up to where we were and just keep declocking the, and just underclock the clock. Oh, this is the one I didn't have all of them for. That's right. I think I put them all back on. I got it. Okay, this will work for now. We'll just use this. Not trying to go for a score, just trying to get this done so I can do the summit. And I want to at least get the summit done today. I have to get the summit done today. Even if we keep crashing and having to restart, I'm going to keep trying because I need to get the summit done. Now I'll try to figure out something later. We just need to do one day of the crew, that's all. Thank you. I accidentally hit the e-brake. Can't wait for them to bring in the beta handling physics so I can actually use the e-brake properly. What? Almost beat GRC Janny. Two blue on a gold race. How disappointing. Jump with ground vehicle. Oh, we got the cookie? And we got a monster Rice Krispie treat, but look at that thing. That thing is monstrous. Buy that cookie. Nom nom nom. Oh my god. I thought that was just at the dinner table. I mean, they never specified where. They just said not to. I assumed, as a dumb kid, they just meant at the dinner table. Everybody goes up there. Need to find a jump. Why did that not have max part? That was weird. Maybe we should do some Rocket League this weekend, man. I haven't been on there in a while. I still want to check out the beach map. Play some hoops. I actually got a couple of buddies who just went to... What is it called? RLCS? They just went to it. Like, they're that into it. They actually went to RLCS. Yeah, I never knew. I had a buddy I grew up with since kindergarten who they play the crap out of Rocket. They really, really love Rocket League. So maybe I can start getting back into that and see just how good they are. OBS just dropped a crap ton of frames just now. There's got to be some underlying issue going on for me to be having all these issues with both PCs. I understand heating and everything, but I can't see how both PCs being hot could be causing so many issues like this. No problems for you? All right. Yeah, we just dropped 754 frames, went down to 0 kbps. Still live and kicking. Yeah, I'm checking. I'm making sure. I don't know if maybe it's because I have this open or... I don't know. OBS has been weird. I think I might download Streamlabs OBS, upload everything to the cloud, and then wipe my systems and start fresh. But yeah, once again, if BMO helps me, I'm hoping he does. We'll be able to get the CPU cooler for the game PC, and then I'll also be able to pick up some extra fans. I'm going to pick up 2 fans for the stream PC and 2 fans for it, for the game PC. And then they should be flowing great again. Yeah. Well, other than my LED melting inside my PC, I don't know if you guys knew about that, but I had a CableMod's LED strip inside my stream PC, and the protective covering for the LEDs melted, and it melted onto my motherboard, onto my fans, onto everything. So maybe that could be causing some issues. I don't know. I really don't. Is that the Nissan 3? Oh, yeah, you saw it. You saw it. Oh, wait, maybe this is what you saw? Sorry, I was even thinking the same thing, too. Yeah, that's I know exactly what you're talking about. Yeah, I actually don't think Nissan has that in here. But as soon as you said, I'm like, yeah, I know exactly what car you're talking about. Yeah, they do kind of look similar. Let me see. I don't think Nissan has that in here. Ray Drift. No. But I felt you there. Oh, okay. I need to change. Sorry. I keep going in and out of this stuff. Need to change air race back to my homeboy. Okay, now there's a jump. It's Florida House. I believe it's at the Florida House. Yeah, it's a Maserati, but I totally understand you because I was thinking the same thing. Like, yeah, man, you know what it is. A redirect? What is this? Oh, right. Yeah, I'm right there with you. I thought it was. Like, yeah, you're right, Nissan. That's the Nissan. You got it. Maybe I'll still make it. Thank you. You know what? I know where we're going. Big Lee, right? That was kind of a big Lee. Well, see, it would be fine if... Well, no, I don't think Restream... Yeah, never mind. Restream doesn't do tiny URL anymore. Should auto-convert URLs to tiny URLs. But I don't think that's in the program anymore. Fuck! I'm just gonna keep bolting up the voltage. It's not overheating anymore. So it's definitely not heat right now that's causing the issue. Might just be voltage is not enough. I'm hoping that's all it is. I mean, it is pretty low. 920 is where it's saying it wants to be. So we'll do I don't know. I'm going to do all I can to get this done. We'll do the jump achievement, and then I'm going to start working on the summit. And hopefully I can get the summit done this time. I can't miss another summit. It's just too much. I want to be ready for July 17th. I got to clean my keyboard too, guys. It is dirty. What's up, Agger? Well, that's what I was going to do. I was going to do that. Because it only needs to be a ground vehicle. It didn't need to be anything specific. That's where I was going to head to. What's going on, man? Maybe you have to run some benchmarks or something this weekend. I got a lot to work on, but a 71 just jumped up. Come on, man. I'm not going to be able to do this. 70, so look, 72. She's getting hotter. Almost bedtime. Just got home from work. I feel you, man. I mean, the idea of how much we work to get things done in this world is crazy. Like, we still haven't moved past the efficiency of 8-hour days. Like I understand people come in, you know, the first hour work is crappy. You know, people are getting into the gist of things, especially on Mondays and the early days of the week. I still don't believe that we should be working 8-hour days. Like, 6-hour days at max. Like, I usually do most of my work in about 6 hours of the day. So if they just cut 2 hours off, instead of having lunch breaks and smoke breaks and all that stuff, you just have, you know, less hours in the day. Now, granted, yeah, people will probably use that to their advantage or whatever. Oh, hey, I could just... I could just take smoke breaks now. Like, yeah. That was my biggest gripe about working. About being in the workplace. I was not a fan of how often cigarette smokers were allowed to just go take breaks. Based on the idea that, well, they're taking a smoke break, you know? So, I can't go just drink. You know what I'm saying? Like, there's always that thing in the back of my head where I'm like, why is it okay for cigarette smokers to get high all day, but I'm not allowed to get high all day? You know? Oh, you know, like I can't, you know, like if I had anything, I can't just go toke up or you know, drink some beer. Like, now, granted, drinking is a different story. I would never drink and work, but as far as smoking and working, sure, why not? But it's illegal, so I can't. So it's just one of those things where it's funny that it's really?